Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you three looks with the new Odin's Eye Legendary Diversa collection. I got all three palettes. I'm gonna do a look with each of the palettes, and I'm also gonna be sharing my first impression thoughts. So I'm really excited about this video, and we're gonna get right into it. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love trying out new makeup, I love trying out new indie makeup, and Odin's Eye is one of the brands that when they release something, I usually at least buy something. This time I bought the whole collection. I could not contain myself, I couldn't choose, so I bought all three palettes and I'm very excited to show them to you guys. I'm just gonna quickly go over them and then we're gonna jump into the three looks. This is one of the looks. So first up we have the Giant Wolves palette by Annette's Makeup Corner. This has beautiful artwork on the front with Annette's face and purple hair, of course, and then the wolves are over here. It's a beautiful grungy color story some pops of brighter colors, which I really like. We have some interesting shimmers in here. We have a multi-chrome shade called Eternal. It's kind of like a blue, silver, pink, purple. There are a lot of shades in there. I'm wearing it right now and I can already tell you that it's really beautiful. Then we have the Red Dragon palette by Judy. I have seen a few videos by her, I think, before she came out with this collaboration, but I didn't know her that well. But I think this is a really pretty palette as well. Beautiful artwork on the front, and inside we have a beautiful kind of rosy warm color story that's more on the neutral side. We have a bright red though, and we have some green shades that kind of add some extra dimension and interest to the palette that make it possible to do some green looks as well. I think this is a really, really pretty color story, and especially a good one if you're a lover of warm neutrals. And then lastly in this collection we have the Hummingbird palette with the Fancy Face. This is a collaborator. This is a YouTuber that I didn't know, but of course once this was revealed I went to check her video, and I think she did some really pretty looks with this palette. So this is the Hummingbird palette. It has a really beautiful artwork on the front as well with the hummingbirds. I love how colorful this is. And then inside we have a little bit more of a tropical color story, but it's still one that you can deepen up. We have some darker shades to kind of ground the look. You can also go a little bit more neutral if you want. We have a neutral shimmer over here called Beach Sands, and we also have this one that's a little bit more of an orangey shimmer, but you can kind of go neutral with that one. So this is kind of like a bright tropical color story, also very fun. With this collection, I believe with every one of these palettes you get a scarf, and I got all three scarves over here. They are they look like this. They have the artwork of the packaging on them. To me, that wasn't completely necessary to add, but I think it's kind of fun. It's just an extra thing that they give you with this collection. I did see that these palettes are gonna be limited edition, but they're gonna be restocking them, I believe, up until January. So if you're interested, you still have some time to get it, but don't wait too long. And I believe these are 27.90 euros each, so they are going to be like $33 each, depends on like the exchange rates, of course. I will put the links and the info in the description box, and there you can go for more information about these palettes. And now let's get into these looks. Okay, so it's time to do the first look, and the first look I'm gonna do is gonna be with the Hummingbird palette, the palette with the Fancy Face. This is a really, really colorful palette. We have a lot of colorful options, and I'm probably gonna do a pretty colorful look, but I also kind of want to see how deep this can get, because we do have some deeper mattes, which I really like in this palette, which I'm really interested in. I think this is such a cool, interesting color story, and there's just so much you can do. So I'm feeling really inspired, but I just have to choose something for this look. And I think I'm gonna go into the shade Hibiscus. I also wanna try the shade which is called Red Hills. I also wanna try Fancy for sure. This is the multi-chrome in this palette. That looks very good. So I'm just gonna go and apply hibiscus in the crease first. This is like a really bright corally red shade. I already primed my eyelids. And now I'm just gonna go in with the crease brush and see how bright the shade is. I think it has a really nice undertone, really nice pinky coral. I think this one adds a lot of vibrancy to the palette. Because even though it looks really vibrant, this palette and the color story, we have some more muted shades in there as well. That's a really, really nice bright matte. That became really bright really fast. I'm definitely happy with how that is looking. Now doing that on the other eye as well. This shade is basically neon. I kind of love it. I kind of think that's really cool. I'm gonna blend a little bit with the clean brush here in the front. I'm thinking I maybe want to try something. I'm thinking I kind of want to take this shade clear blue and kind of put that towards the inner part of the crease. I don't know if it's gonna be pigmented enough, but I just want to try some things out because I just feel really inspired. So I'm kind of placing that here, and I don't know if this is gonna work or what's gonna happen, but let's see. I feel like it's kind of becoming a more cool toned pink. I like that. I actually like that. It's definitely not becoming blue, but it's an interesting combo. It's interesting to kind of blend these shades together. I quite like what that did. I'm just gonna go in with the brush with the bright pink again to blend that in the middle. Okay, I like what that did. I didn't know. That wasn't exactly what I expected, but I think it looks cool. I like it. Okay, now I want to go into the shade called Red Hills. This one over here. Just gonna take a crease brush. This looks kind of like a dark red brown. I don't really want this to take over the look, but I do want to add a little bit of depth here and see how these shades blend together. I do want to keep the look bright. I do want to make sure that that pink is still visible there. That was like really pigmented, really easy to apply, and almost no effort. Okay, nice. So adding this to the outer corner. That's a really good matte. I have to be honest, the matte formula by Odin's Eye, so far I felt like it was good, but it wasn't my favorite. But I really like the mattes in here. I really like how this is working out, how this is looking. I think I'm gonna go back in with the hibiscus shade and just intensify that a little bit, just making sure that it's all blended and that we still have that vibrant pink in the middle of the crease there. Don't want to lose that shade. I'm just gonna take a brush to kind of blend out the edges, but I still want to keep the pigment, so I'm just gonna go over the edges. I'm not gonna blend too much. Okay, so you can take that shade Red Hills and kind of deepen up the look and kind of make it more defined without it looking super super crazy dark right away. I really like that. You can build it up and you can kind of have control over how bright or deep or smoky the look is. I'm kind of thinking what I want to do. I kind of want to give Fancy its moments, but then probably I'm gonna put one of the other shimmers on the lower lash line. So I'm gonna take this shimmer. It kind of looks purple, blue, gold. It looks really nice. And I'm gonna take that on my finger and apply that to the lid. It's really, really smooth in the pan. It's not like a really textured shade. Sometimes Odin's Eye does really textured shimmers, but sometimes they can do really smooth, really soft and silky multi-chromes as well. This is such a beautiful shade. It's blue, it's gold, it's purple. I hope you can kind of see that on camera, but this is like one of the most beautiful shimmers I've had on my eyes. Wow. Look at how this looks on my finger. Just look at this. It's so magical. Just applying that over here. There are so many colors in this shade. And I love a good purple and gold duochrome shade. This is really, really pretty. It's a smooth shimmer, but really shiny, really reflective. It has so many shifts in there. I think that looks amazing. Okay, now I'm gonna take a brush and I'm gonna take a little bit of Red Hills and put that in the outer part to kind of deepen up the outer corner a little bit more. Not too much. I feel like this will make the look a little bit more cohesive, but you still have like the shimmer underneath there. It kind of brings out the gold in that shimmer. I'm already kind of sad that I will have to take this off in a little bit to do the next look. This is looking so good. I love it. Okay. For the lower lash line, I just want to do something else. I want to do something different. Do I want to do something blue? Yeah, I kind of want to try the blues as well. Okay, I'm gonna first go in with a little bit of a mix between Lagoon and this light clear blue shade. I'm gonna put a little bit of both on my brush because I don't want to make the lower lash line super, super dark in comparison to the top. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of Lagoon and then also a little bit of clear blue. See how this is gonna mix. Now it's more of a bright aqua blue. It's a little bit of a powdery shade. I'm gonna have to clean that up a little bit, but I do think it's a cool combo. Just gonna do the same over here, trying to not get it everywhere. I feel like that clear blue shade, because it's such a light powdery kind of shade, it kind of is powdery in formula. I think I'm just gonna take a little bit of Star Apple and kind of put it in the outer part of the lower lash line and then maybe blend it in a little bit with the top. But I just want to keep it pretty light. This is kind of like an inky blue or purplish dark smoky blue. Okay, it's looking a bit crazy right now. I hope it's gonna look better when I apply mascara. Probably it's gonna come together, but ooh. Okay. So I'm gonna take a little bit of Star Apple and I hope this is gonna work. I'm gonna put a little bit over here and kind of blend this into each other. Kind of want to make this look like it's all part of the same look. I just take the tiniest bit on my brush and just put it in the very, very outer corner. I feel like it kind of works because it has that purpley undertone to it. It doesn't become like extremely muddy, but it did add some depth to the look for sure. Okay, I want to go into... I think I want to add something to the lower lash line to make it a little bit brighter. And I'm going to go into the shade called Tropics. This greeny blue shade over here. This looks like a bit of a smooth shimmer, not as textured as some of these look. But I didn't really go into the textured shades this time. But I know that I really like the textured shades, usually from Odin's Eye. I do think those are really good. So taking the shade Tropics and just applying that to the lower lash line to add a little bit of shine and brightness. It was all looking a little bit dark. I really like this shade. It's easy to apply. Some shades don't really apply well to the lower lash line, but this one definitely did. Now, I don't really have anything for the lower lash line in this palette, so I'm not entirely sure what I want to do with that. Maybe I can just take that matte shade, the clear blue shade, and put that in the inner corner. And this is like a very experimental look for me. I usually keep it pretty simple when I do reviews, but I just wanted to try some different things out. Also because I know that I like the Odin's Eye formula. It's nothing new to me. I've tried a bunch of their things. So that's why I feel inspired to do some things differently than I usually do. And of course it's a really colorful palette, so then I just want to play with some color. And I feel like we have a shade on the top and on the bottom that kind of blends into this light blue color. So that's kind of working out. This is a very, very interesting look. This has become an interesting look. Okay, I'm gonna add some liner. I'm gonna put on the rest of my makeup. And then I will show you the finished look. I'm really curious to see what this is gonna look like with mascara and everything on. this is a different kind of look for me. Alright, and this is the final look. I really, really love how this turned out. I love how colorful this is, how impactful these mattes look. And the shimmers that I've tried are really, really gorgeous, really beautiful. Especially that fancy shade that I put on the lid. Absolutely amazing. It looks so, so good. I will link everything else that I used down below in the description box. I just quickly threw on some makeup that is in my project pan. I will give you a little bit of a close-up so you can kind of see better what this is looking like. It is so good. I like this palette more than I thought that I would. I mean, these mattes are really, really great, really blendable, really pigmented. I love how these all work together. I'm kind of sad that I have to take this off. I don't feel like I'm ready to take this off, but I have to film the other look. And of course, I forgot to take off the mascara that I smudged on my lid. Okay, I'm gonna take some photos of this look and then I'm gonna be right back and I'm gonna do another look with the Red Dragon palette, I think. Okay, same day, a different outfit, different eyeshadow look. We're gonna be playing with the Red Dragon palette. I tried to take off the other look as good as I possibly could. I think I can work with this. It isn't perfect, but I can definitely blend some other eyeshadows on top. And I already primed my eyes. Did forget to pose for the thumbnail though, so it's going really well. I usually don't really do multiple looks a day, but I feel like with three palettes, I don't want filming for these palettes to take forever and then be really late with putting this up. Okay, so we have some really, really nice rosy tones in here. That's kind of what attracted me to this palette the most, because these tones are not exactly super, super warm. They are warm, but in a rosy way, and I really, really like that. But the greens in here also look really pretty. This one called Solar Flare, it looks so good. And the jade shade, it's a bit like warm and murky for my taste, but I think I can definitely incorporate that in some looks. I think I'm gonna make the outer part of the look a little bit warm, rosy, and more of a neutral look. And then the inner part of the eye, I kind of want to go in with the greens there. So I think I'm just going to go in with the shade Serene in the outer corner first. And then I'm going to take the shade Gin, I think. I'm going to put that on top to deepen that up a little bit. I'm actually really, really excited about this basic palette. I know it's basic, but these are shades that I know I want to wear a lot. Okay, I'm gonna zoom you in a little bit more. Just a little bit. Let's do the next look. I'm gonna go into Serene and I'm gonna put that in the outer corner only. This is a bit more of a warm shade, definitely. A bit more of a peachy neutral. I think it will go together with the other shades in the palette very well. This is pretty pigmented and I can build it up. It's a nice transition shade for this palette. I like how that is looking. Now for the next shade, I'm just gonna take the same brush. I'm just gonna put that a little bit more towards the outer corner and blend that. This is such a pretty shade. All right, this is already giving me quite a nice amount of depth. And for a more soft, everyday look, you could keep it like this. But I think I'm gonna go a little bit deeper and just make it a little bit more smoky. So I'm gonna take a smaller brush and I think I'm gonna go into Fire. This looks like a really pretty shade. It's like almost like a dark maroon color, almost. It's like a really interesting undertone. And I'm just gonna take a little bit on my brush and just place it in the outer corner and see if this is gonna build. Okay, this is not a lot darker than the other shade, or it's not really building up. It's like a slight difference if you build it up, but it's not like what I expected it to be. I was expecting a little bit more. So building it up on this side, it does build, but it's just not as impactful as I thought it was gonna be. I don't know if it's the shade or the formula that causes that. I'm just gonna blend this a little bit with the brush that I already used. Okay, I'm gonna fix this. It looks a little bit messy under here, but I'm gonna fix it in the end. I think I'm just gonna take a little bit of Aurora and see if that can really deepen the outer corner. Just a little bit here, seeing if that can make a difference. I'm of course adding a lot of mattes on each other. So with some formulas, there's like a limit of how many mattes you can keep adding. I do feel like this kind of added some depth, but it's not like crazy. It's nothing too crazy deep and smoky. I do like how this looks in the end, but I feel like it took a little bit of time to end up here. I don't mind it, but if you want to go very, very deep, it's not like bam, one swipe depth in your look. All right, let's move on to the greens. I'm gonna go into the shade called Jade. Over here, and I'm gonna apply that towards the inner part of the crease. And I'm really curious to see how pigmented that is. That's nice. I like that amount of pigmentation. It does show up pretty well. It's like an addition, a little addition of color. It's kind of like a soft, murky, warm green that I think works very well with warm shades like this. I don't know if I would personally go into these greens a lot, but I do think they're pretty. It's just that I don't feel like they look very good on me. And I'm gonna take the brush that I just used, and I'm just gonna blend a little bit here where I didn't really want the green. You know, I think in the end I got quite a bit of depth from this palette, but I just had to work a little bit harder for it than I thought. What should we do? I think this shade called Luna looks really interesting because it kind of looks like purpley maroon, but when you like tilt the palette, it looks kind of green. I don't know if I can show you here. Probably in the swatches. I'm gonna try to show you in the swatches, but it kind of looks like a mix between the shades because it's warm but also green when you tilt it. So I think I want to try that on the lid. So it feels a very smooth. It's not a textured shimmer. It's the same as the multi-chrome in the Hummingbird palette. That looks really nice. That's a really nice shimmer. It's not like it's completely smooth, but the shimmer that is in here is like extremely fine. I think that's such a cool shimmer. It's kind of like gold, maroony, and then also green. Okay, I really, really like that. I think I want to add a little bit of a more textured shimmer as well. I think I want to add a little bit of the shade called Overheat, and I want to put that a little bit in the inner, or the in the middle of the lid. Gonna take a little bit of that on my finger and just adding a little bit of texture. Just a bit over here. I think that added a little bit of brightness to the look, which I really, really like. That's a really, really pretty shimmer. I feel like those shimmers go together very well. I think that was really, really cool. Now I just want to put a little bit of the shade Solar Flare, actually, but I hope it's not going to be too dark for the inner part. I feel like my camera is kind of confused because sometimes when I look up and I look in a viewfinder, I look very orange, and then sometimes I just look normal. I don't know what's going on. Maybe it's because the lighting is changing and it's a bit dark. Okay, so I'm going to go into the shade called Solar Flare, which is the green shimmer. It's also a little bit textured. Gonna put that towards the inner part. Wow, that's a bright shimmer. That's a bright green. That is really nice. That's beautiful. I love that. This is the type of shimmer that I love Odin's Eye for. They do this kind of, how would you call it? It's almost creamy, kind of thick shimmer, and when you apply it, it just looks so impactful. It just looks so special. I do feel like it emphasizes texture a little bit, but it's so pretty though. I really liked it. For the lower lash line, I think I want to keep it a little bit more cool toned. I think I'm going to go into the shade called Sunrise. It's a bit of a mustardy shade, but it does give me some cool tone vibes. And then I'm going to go into the shade called Claw to kind of deepen that up. Just applying the mustard to the lower lash line. I feel like this is a perfect bridge between the warm tones and the greens. But a mustard can also, it can look a little bit taupey if combined with certain shades. I'm gonna go into the shade called Claw. I'm definitely gonna have to clean up under my eyes a little bit. This is why I usually don't ever do my face first, because I always get this where it's a little bit too low and I just go overboard a little bit, and it's easier to clean if I don't have anything on my cheeks just yet. So now it's looking a bit crazy, but I'm gonna fix it. Now I just want to go into another shimmer. And I think I'm going to go into the shimmer called Amber. This rose goldy shimmer over here. And I just want to put that on the lower lash line. And then I think we've basically used all the shades in this palette except for the bright red. I don't know what I was thinking. How could I? Maybe, I don't know, I don't think I can really add it in anymore. Okay, the shade called Amber. I think this is more of a smooth metallic. Okay, I think that's really pretty. This is really a palette where now I'm doing such an intricate look with all the shades, but I'm actually looking forward to doing pretty basic looks with this. Keeping it a little bit more neutral with a special shimmer to kind of spice up the look. I feel like this shimmer doesn't grab onto the lower lash line as well as some others, but it still looks pretty. It still looks nice. In this palette, there's also not really an inner corner highlight. I'm gonna try the shade Overheat as an inner corner, but I don't know if that's gonna work. Otherwise, I'm gonna put something a bit lighter in the inner corner. Don't know if this is working. I guess it's not bad, but it's also not really giving me what I want. So I think I'm gonna put something else in the inner part on top. Yeah, I think it's just a little bit too deep for inner corners. It doesn't seem like this is a collab that is about the inner corner highlights. I do believe there's one in the Annette palette, but these palettes that I tried today, they don't really have that. Okay, I'm gonna fix this eyeshadow. I'm gonna put some mascara on again. And then I'm gonna be right back and chat with you about this look. And this is the result. This is look number 2. And I actually really, really like it. These shimmers are really, really nice. I love it. I love the shimmer that's kind of like maroon to green that I have in the outer corners. I love the green and the brighter shimmer that I put on the rest of the lid. I really, really think this is a great look. I think this palette is a bit lighter. Even though these shades, you can deepen up your look, it's a little bit lighter, it's a little bit softer. You can do more everyday looks with this. I think if you put one of these down first, you can get a little bit more smoky. I will have to try that out, but it was a little bit more work, it was a little bit more difficult to really, really deepen this up. I don't really mind that. I think it looks good in the end, but if you're someone who is hoping for like a really deep smoky look, I'm not entirely sure yet if this is the palette for that. But I really actually love these greens that are in here that make the palette a little bit more interesting. And I actually like them more on my eyes than I was thinking I would. So I'm generally really, really excited about this palette and really happy with this palette. And I think it looks really cute and gives you some nice neutral options. I will give you a little bit of a close-up so you can see what the shimmers look like from up close. I really love the look of that green. It's such a nice, murky, shiny green. Really, really cool. So yeah, that's gonna be it for the second look. Okay, it's time to play with the Annette palette today. Time to play with the Giant Wolves eyeshadow palette. And this was actually the one I was the most excited about. This is the YouTuber that I personally follow the most. And this was the color story that I thought looked very cool, very fall appropriate. So I can't wait to do a look with this. And looking at this, there are so many things I want to do. There are so many options here. I'm gonna try to use as many of the shades as I can, but I just want to do more looks with this. I just want to do more looks than one with this, actually. I just see so many options here. But for today, I think I'm gonna start out with putting this shade Ablaze in the crease. It looks like a beautiful kind of pinky purple that is not too dark. I'm just gonna take a crease brush. I already applied some primer. So let's see how easy this is to use as a transition shade and how easy this blends. I feel like this is blending very easily. I feel like the mattes in this new collection so far, what I've tried, are really, really good. I really, really like the mattes. They're pigmented, blendable. I really like them. All right, that was pretty easy to apply. Let's do the same on the other eye. I'm just blending this out, trying to make it look even. I think this is a really pretty shade for the crease. I think next I want to go into the shade. I think I'm going to go into the shade called Howling over here. It looks kind of like, how would you describe this? Kind of like a plummy shade almost, but very dark and very blackened. And I'm just gonna take the same brush that I just used and I'm gonna deepen up the outer corner. And let's see how deep we can get this palette, because I know Annette really likes deepening up her look. She really likes black. She likes a lot of contrast as well. All right, that was really, really easy to apply. No problems at all with this deep shade. I don't have to work hard for these mattes at all. And often with darker shades in the crease, you have to be a little bit careful with blending, but this is like so easy to use. This, I feel, is gonna be quite a quick and easy look. Okay, now for the lid. Yeah, I think I'm gonna move on to the lid now. I'm gonna put down a bit of the shade Azure first. I'm just gonna take a bit of a flat brush. And I'm gonna put that down a little bit towards the outer part here. I feel like that pink and this blue are such pretty shades together. I love this color combo. What do I want to do? And now I think I'm gonna put Eternal, the multichrome shade in this palette, on top of the whole lid. I'm just gonna take that with my finger. This one once again feels very smooth. And I'm gonna put that on top of the blue to really make the blue base of the shimmer come out. But then I'm gonna put it towards the inner part as well. And I'm kind of trying to blend it all together. That is such a cool shade. It's such a good layering shade as well. On top of the blue, it really makes the shimmer look so blue. But then without anything underneath, it's more light and kind of pinky, kind of silvery almost. I think this looks really cool. Can definitely see all the shifts on the lid. Though these are not multichromes where you're like, is it a multichrome or not? These are definitely really shifty shades. Okay, I really, really like this look so far. I kind of want to do something with one of the darker shimmers. We have this shade called Hottie, I believe that it was called, and the shade called Skull. And those are both a little bit of a deeper shimmer. I might want to put one of them a little bit towards the outer corner. I think I'm gonna put a little bit of Skull over here. I'm gonna put a little bit of that on my finger and then apply it towards the outer part here to kind of deepen it all up. I hope it's not gonna cover up everything I just did. Kind of blending that. I just want it at the very, very outer part of the lid so I can still see that bright blue. I like how that kind of deepened up the look, added a little bit more of dimension to the eye. Even though we already had so much dimension with that Eternal shade, that's such a special shade. Okay, for the lower lash line, I think I'm gonna go into the shade Azure first. Then I'm gonna put a little bit of Cosmos, this kind of inky blue, purpley blue shade on top. And then I think I'm gonna put a bit of Haiti in the inner part of the lower lash line. So starting out with the brighter blue shade. And then I'm gonna take that Cosmo shade, that kind of deeper blue, and deepening that up over here. Just the outer part, and I'm kind of connecting that to the upper crease. Just blending that upward a little bit, not too much. And now I'm gonna take a pencil brush and I'm gonna take the shade Haiti and I'm gonna put that on the lower lash line. This is one that doesn't pick up the best with my pencil brush. Just have to go in a little bit. But that's a pretty shade. This is more of a textured shimmer. Oh, it does work. You just have to go in a little bit more. I think this one is a little bit harder pressed than the other shimmers. Okay, I think that looks pretty. I don't know if you really see it on camera, but it's a pretty kind of bluish purple, shimmery textured shade. And now for the last part of this look, I want to go into the shade called Astral. I saw that Annette used this in the inner corner so much and I was really curious to see what this one was like. It looks a bit like a white to goldish duochrome in the pan. At this point I haven't swatched anything. Yes, that looks like a really pretty inner corner highlight. This picks up quite easily on my pencil brush. And now I think I just want to add one more thing. I'm gonna go in with a flat brush, but just like the top of the flat brush. I'm gonna go into the shade Cosmos, that dark blue shade, and just apply a little bit to the lash line just to get a little bit of smokiness and to make the whole look come together. All right, that's a really easy shade to use on a lash line. It is pigmented, it blends out easily. Really love how that looks. I'm gonna finish up the rest of my makeup and then I will be right back to chat about this palette a little bit. So this is a finished look and I really, really love it. I love how this looks. Just the shimmer, how it looks under the blue matte, how I layered everything on top of each other. I really like how that came out. Love the combination of the purpley pink with the blue. I love this look. I think these shimmers are gorgeous. These mattes worked very well, blended out so easily. I'm so, so into this look. So once again, I will give you a little bit of a close-up so you can maybe get a glimpse of that multichrome shade. It's a bit hard to really show on camera. I hope you can kind of see it, but I'm really, really into this look. I love this palette so far. So let me just quickly round up my first impression thoughts. I think I said a lot about this already and it's gonna be a pretty long video, so I'm gonna try and keep it short. But I think that this collection is just so well thought out. I love how they did this. I love how all these palettes are so complementary to each other. You have a more grungy one, a more neutral one, and then a more bright one. And I can see so many different looks just combining these palettes. And I just love how diverse this collection actually is and that they just picked different influencers that had their own thing to add to this collection. I'm just really, really impressed. I love how they did a multichrome in every palette. I think that just adds something interesting, extra special to it, and it just makes it more fun to do looks, I think, to just have a little bit of a special shimmer in there. I love how there are different textures. Some of the shimmers are a bit more smooth, some have more of a texture and dimension to them, some have a bit more duochrome. I'm just a big fan of Onyx Eye, and once again, I think they did a really, really great job. I think this is such a beautiful collection, and I loved every look that I did with it. I'm just really excited. I'm just really into it and I can't wait to use these palettes more. So I think that's gonna be everything for this video. Let me know in the comments what you think about these palettes. Did you pick any of them up? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it and don't forget to subscribe. And then I will see you in my next one. Bye bye.